Morning, Chris. How are you doing today?
Hi, Ron. Doing great. How about yourself?
Doing great. So we're following up with another webinar, and this will be number two that was generated from an event Chris and I went to last week in Chicago, and a number of people that attended the event brought up some great topics, right? And while they were fresh on our mind, we wanted to make sure to cover those. So one of the questions that came up, most of the evening we talked about AI, right? That was a big one. We were talking about AI. And it wasn't just AI and e-commerce, it was AI and online and e-commerce and data analysis and, you know, personalization and a whole bunch of different things that we can cover in future webinars. This one was a really interesting one. It was, and I'm going to turn it over to you to kind of answer the question. I know conceptually how to do it, but you know technically how to do it. So let's say, for example, I wanted to intelligently use AI to respond to visitors, to people, to clients, to different things. How can I use AI to help me more intelligently respond and communicate with my audience? Because there's a lot in my audience, right? If I'm online Yes. e-commerce, if I'm a doctor, it's patients. I mean, there's so many. Who is my audience, number one? And how can I intelligently, and how do you foresee AI helping us respond to those that we want to communicate with?
Great question. So one of the things that I think a lot of folks don't necessarily think about that is part of the AI equation is getting the data and getting really good data for AI. The way I like to say it is it's like training a new team member. A lot of companies, their teams are made up of folks that have a lot of tribal knowledge. So when someone new gets started, the team just kind of shares all their knowledge in conversation and interactions, and that brings the new person up to speed. With AI, it's kind of like you have the opportunity to hire one of the most talented team members in the world, but you basically need to give them kind of feed them the right training information, the right data. And so this is a really key part of the equation. And I just want to call that out, and we can kind of unpack that in a minute. The other piece, just to get to the heart of your question, which I think is what most people are interested in, is there are so many compelling ways to use AI with the right training. It can be very effective. Some examples of that would be taking chat interactions that your team has had. This can be any way that has been persisted so that it can be translated back to the AI for training. But essentially, a lot of chat interactions happen on, you know, most folks' websites, and there are transcripts of those chats. And so those can be ranked and basically verified as this was a good chat, this is a good chat response, this was a valid potential customer, and this was not a good chat and not a good chat response, etc. So with that data, we can literally train the AI to respond like your best customer service person would. Now, this can then be progressed to some really interesting things where we can look at things like follow-up and direct outreach to potential customers, depending on the situation. This gets into things like transactional email based on behavior. So we can see, you know, what is the behavior of a user on the site. Maybe they have, you know, just kind of a classical scenario where they've abandoned the cart, or they're just interacting with the site in real time, and we want to change their experience to be more catered to them. This is a classical model of personalization, but just doing it in a much more intelligent way with AI that's fine-tuned for your business. So it's possible to send really specific follow-up email. It's possible to change the results of the page that they're on your website, for example, to reflect better that particular user's interactions on the site and what they might be looking for. And even to do things where we're sort of like taking a page out of the playbook of a sales team member or transactional email that may have been sent manually, we can do that in an automated fashion. And it's not just necessary, Ron, to train with past experiences and past interactions that someone on your team has had. We can also give the instruction to the AI based on different scenarios. And one of the things that, you know, we do a lot is we'll create training data that is based on business logic and algorithms. We can basically tell the AI to create training data for itself or use a tool like GPT-4o or something like that and generate good training data for your AI instance to then model from. So without going too much into the weeds further, the point is it can do a lot and it's really, really powerful to automate a lot of the steps in the process that, let's just be really frank about it. Right now, they probably aren't going to happen unless they're done in an automated way because they're too time consuming, right?
Right. So it was interesting. You brought up both past and present and positive and negative, and I loved it. So I want to go into a little bit of that and make sure that I'm understanding that, just so like all the business people that heard this that aren't as technical understood it too. So the thing that was interesting when you said about training data and even the chat logs, right? That made a lot of sense to me, you know? So we got Tyler on our team who manages our live chat. And so Tyler answers a lot of questions, right? And so we could literally go through that log and go, oh, good answer, Tyler, blah, 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 blah. And we could tag all the ones that he answered that were really good. And then you also get people, you get trolls every once in a while on the site and they come in and ask a stupid question. And so you have to respond accordingly. And then you can also go in. And so what you're saying is not only can we take the good stuff that he responded, we can also tell the tool, here are some examples of questions that are dumb, or here are examples of questions that shouldn't be asked or answers that shouldn't be given. So stay away from this. Or if somebody asks this type of question, send them away kindly or whatever. So you're saying we can train both the positive and the negative. That was an interesting thing that you talked about.
Yes. And just to elaborate briefly and then back to you, this is probably one of the biggest things that we see from businesses that they really want, because we don't want the AI to hallucinate with a customer. I mean, what could be worse than giving bad information? So we want to be probably more prescriptive and clear about what its boundaries are than, you know, than anything, so that if it doesn't know, it doesn't say that it knows, and it doesn't allow there to be an implication or any kind of inference that it knows something that it just doesn't. So back to you.
Yeah. And then the other one that you said that was really interesting was the past versus present. I really like that. So theoretically, training on chat logs would be an option of past. A present, which I think is much more around the personalization, is interesting. So I'd like to talk a little bit about that. I'm going to throw out some ideas and then I want you to kind of talk deeper in that. So things I'm thinking of is, you know, Ron goes to an online storefront and I start looking at products. I'm assuming you could pre-program things like, hey, if Ron looks at three products and hasn't added anything to his cart, but he's on the site, looked at either three products or been on the site for longer than 3 minutes, go ahead and serve him up a 10% off coupon to see if that'll help entice him to make a purchase, right? That would be an example. If Ron searches for these types of things, automatically serve up these top sellers or these lost leaders or these bonuses or promotions or deals that we have going on within that category or anything related to that product. Or additional personalization could be used for, you know, you always hear the joke about don't forget your batteries, right? Around Christmas time, you see all the ads. It's like, don't forget the battery. You buy all the toys for the kids for Christmas, you open the toys and then there's no batteries, right?
Yeah.
And so you could use AI to do that kind of thing. You could program AI for all the different types of accessories, the different cross sells, the different upsells, and those kinds of things. I know most of my examples are e-commerce. I know we've done some live AI with voice recognition and medical related too, right? Where people are calling in and they're talking about conditions and things like that. And based on that live conversation, the AI is either directing them to a specific, either scheduling their appointment for them automatically 24/7 or sending them to a specific doctor or forward them over to emergency or giving them medical advice. There's some really interesting things in the real-time interaction that we've done with AI there as well. So I'm really interested in to hear a little more about your thoughts on how the AI tools work with that past versus present and that training and giving it that information that you're talking about that helps really teach it how to behave, right? Like you've said it before on our previous webinar, you said a new AI library is like getting a brand new, whatever, MBA graduate, right? They've got all this great little bit of knowledge about everything and they know how to do stuff, but they don't know anything specific about your business. So it's like getting a fresh grad and then you bring them in and every business takes the first 2 or 3 months to quote unquote, get them up to speed. Well, that get them up to speed is the same thing in training an AI. We have to get the AI up to speed on how to respond, how to react, what to say, what voice we're doing, what promotions we want to do, what's most important for personalization, how to react in all the different types of scenarios. That's literally what the training is getting the AI up to speed because they're a brand new employee and they don't know anything about the business, right?
Right. Yes. So that's a really interesting area to dig into because that's where this becomes practical for folks. And as a summary, basically any of the processes that, you know, we can provide specific training or resources, like you said, past versus present, we can generally get the AI to do something that's going to help move the process forward. And it's really helpful to look at this both from a customer interaction perspective, but also from an internal perspective too. A lot of our clients are working with AI for internal team members and helping them to either automate or sort of, you know, keep the standards higher with the way things are operated, sort of getting awareness faster about things. So I'll give a few examples of both. For the example of an internal team member and using AI, it could be used to look at when someone goes to the site, they don't complete anything, but maybe they either log in or we just use anonymous IP lookup. And we can see that that visitor is assigned to a certain territory or salesperson. And so we can notify that group that that visitor came to the site and give them a path and then maybe even make a recommended sort of next set of steps based on best practices within our organization for what's getting the best results whenever somebody takes this behavior. If you do these things, it works best. And so that's just one example. So that might be, you know, these folks visited these pages. There's a lead magnet that we're sending that's free as a follow-up that's really working for visitors that go to these pages but don't check out or don't submit a form. And by the way, if you tend to send it within the first 60 minutes of them visiting, you'll get a much higher response. And I've already drafted the email for you that you can send with that lead magnet. You know, did you know that we had this resource on blah, blah, blah? It looks like you were looking at da, da, da. Just wanted to make sure you have whatever you need, you know, et cetera. So things like that can be really helpful. And AI is really good at generating that kind of content and making those kind of connections. Another example would be, you know, possibly something internal where we're using big data, power, you know, business intelligence, and essentially KPIs. But having the AI look at that and monitor it and provide notifications based on that. So just sort of like interpreting that information via AI to notify folks, give maybe a manager a notification. And so just kind of helping people get through all the information. Typically, there's a lot of information that's sort of being shared and iterated on. And so it can be really, really helpful to get it quickly. And I won't go into a bunch more details, but suffice to say there are endless scenarios within an organization where there's inefficiency and AI can help. But it's really important that it be, set up properly so that it's fine tuned for your organization and for your scenarios. That's when it's going to perform at its best. Otherwise, it really doesn't have a fighting chance at being super accurate and super helpful.
Right. So is there anything else you want to tie us up? I think that's great for covering this topic. And then we'll go back. If you want to see any other topics about AI, especially while it's fresh on our mind and while we're talking a lot about AI, please comment below and we'll see if we can't do a quick webinar. Otherwise, we hope to see you on the next webinar. And please reach out if you need any help. Bye for now.
Thanks for watching. Bye for now.